So today we have a resolution which is honoring Community Planning Month.
What started as a routine city council meeting eventually turning to protest. Members of the Coalition for Justice for Jamar showing up to propose what they're calling a Minneapolis Police Accountability Council. They say they want the all-elected council to rewrite the police handbook, investigate all police shootings, and have the final authority when it comes to the discipline of officers.
And what we need is community control of the Minneapolis Police Department.
We don't want another Philando Castile, Terrence Franklin, Fong Lee, Marcus Golden, or Jamar Clark. We need police accountability.
Jamar Clark was shot and killed during a scuffle with two Minneapolis police officers in November of 2015. Ultimately, no charges or discipline handed out to the officers involved. Jamar's family, among those who showed up today to protest and call for change.
And I'm here as Jamar Clark's stepfather, and I'm speaking in behalf of his mother for justice for Jamar. The tears don't ever stop when the police go to bed.
I guess this is my opportunity right now to come from behind the curtains and just let people see the real deal when a loved one, your loved one, is taken away from you. And I just thank everybody here today because they give me hope and let me know that the fight has just begun.
In Minneapolis, Brian Pyatt, Carol 11 News.
Protesters also joined forces with the Minnesota Immigrant Rights Action Committee at City Hall today to call for action to support local immigrants and refugees. After the protest, the City Council voted to approve two ordinances regulating short-term rentals in Minneapolis. The new regulations will allow the city to track the number of short-term rental units in the city and to require hosting companies like Airbnb to advertise only properties that have registered or obtained a rental license.